The iconic Times Square New Year's Eve ball gets a new design. The redesign features a bow tie lighting pattern. The organizers say it reflects the history of Times Square, which was once known as the bow tie. On New Year's Eve, the ball will gracefully descend from the summit of One Times Square, marking a bright start to 2024.
This has been a tough year by any measure. Each year, I always look forward to the next year. It's a time of reflection on the past. It's a time of honoring the present and celebrating the present, but celebrating the hope of the future. 2024 is going to be a great year, and I'd like everyone to focus on the positive in 2024. We've had a lot of negative in 2023, and it's time to look for the good, not the bad.
Now, a Filipino-Canadian artist fulfills a longtime dream to turn his home into his very own Christmas wonderland. Take a look.
An apartment in Edmonton is home to a fantastic collection of Christmas village decor. It's been the dream of Filipino-Canadian Albert Isguera to set up a Christmas village. He has made his dream come true by completing, in 5 months, a Christmas village inside his two-bedroom apartment.
We Filipinos love Christmas so much. As a child, I had a dream of building cardboard houses during my childhood days. Underneath our Christmas tree, I usually gather some cardboards and then make a house underneath them. And then when I came to Canada, I have seen these ceramic pieces. So I was so amazed and fascinated about how they look like and how detailed they are. So it's quite expensive though. So I said to myself, I'm just gonna buy and look for in the thrift store. So I found some and then started collecting.
Isguera dreams of becoming an artist and wants to build, create, and design just about anything. He and his family love Christmas and wants to celebrate it in them to enjoy.
These pieces, I gathered them 13 years ago. Since I came to Canada, I started collecting one piece at a time. If I see one in the thrift store, and then within the 13 years, I gathered a lot, and when my family came over, but it took me 5 months to build this one. 5 months, and then it took me 1 hour or 2 a day, or some full hours on my days off.
Isguera shares that it takes a lot of patience and perseverance to complete this Christmas village. One, he says, must be attentive to details. But if you love what you're doing, it is a lot of fun putting them together. Isguera adds that 13 years of collecting the materials and 5 months of putting this Christmas village together is nothing compared to the joy of seeing it become a reality. He now has a YouTube channel known as Artistic Dad, where he shows people how to put stuff together, like a fairy house, pirate ship, dollhouse, and more, using cardboard. Isguera dreams that one day he'll be able to put together a show where people can see and enjoy his work. Marjorie Carmona Newman, ABS-CBN News, Edmonton.
Nearly 24 more people are hurt by firecrackers in the Philippines just days before the New Year's Eve festivities. Rafael Bosano has more.
Operating equipment have been laid out on a table in this small room in Tondo Medical Center's emergency department. Doctors here hope that they won't have to use them even if the days leading up to the new year have historically been chaotic for several hospitals. Since December 21, 6 individuals have already been brought to the hospital for treatment for firework-related injuries. This is just a few patients lower from the 11 recorded during the entire surveillance period of last year's celebration. But not all of the patients were directly involved in lighting a firecracker.
Dalawa yung mga natalsikan lang ng mga paputok or pwedeng nahagisan, then tinamaan lang sila. Sa tingin ko, kailangan talaga nating maghigpit, i-regulate yung pagbebenta ng paputok para hindi na makakuha yung mga common na mga tao, para hindi na sila maka-purchase.
Dr. Villamayor says a common denominator among most patients, alcohol intoxication. Throughout the country, six individuals have had to undergo amputation after their injuries severely damaged their body part. Unfortunately, victims of firecracker injuries are getting younger.
Sa datos natin, no, ang median age ng mga new cases kahapon 13.5 years. Ngayon, yung pinaka-latest report, 12 years. Yung paputok na yan, di ba, minsan sasabihin, baka nga para bang senyales ng pagkalalaki. Kasi, uy, kaya ko magsindi ng fireworks. O kaya, parang ano to, rite of passage. Karaniwan nangyayari yan eh. Eh, kung ang rite of passage na gagawin mo ay mawalan ka ng kamay, at lalo na kung ang kamay na to ay yung tinatawag na dominant hand.
The DOH explains all types of firecrackers are dangerous regardless if they're legal or not.
Pero sa aming mga doktor, sa doktor ng medisina, lahat yan sumasabog eh. Kahit 0.3, 0.2, pag pumutok yan at naputokan yung daliri mo, eh wala tayong legal or illegal. Putol yung daliri mo, di ba?
Should individuals insist on continuing this dangerous tradition, Domingo has one advice. If it doesn't go off, don't pick it up.
Karaniwan yung mga hindi pumuputok, hindi sumisindi, yung pala meron pang konting sindi, tas lalapit, ayun, sasabog sa mata, bulag. Or hahawakan, tas ilalapit sa muka, gaganon, sabog ang kamay, tama ang mata. So iwanan na lang kapag tawag dun sa English yung dud, hindi sumindi, hindi sumabog, huwag nang pansinin.
Aside from physical injuries, lighting firecrackers are also potential sources of residential fire. This is why the DOH, along with other agencies and local governments, advocate for watching fireworks in designated community shows where there are trained professionals. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Humanoid robots are poised to play a greater role on Earth and beyond in the coming years. This report introduces us to NASA's Valkyrie.
Meet Valkyrie, NASA's humanoid robot. Standing over 6 feet tall and weighing 300 pounds, she cuts an imposing figure. She is designed to operate in challenging environments, such as areas hit by natural disasters. But she could also one day operate in space.
So we're not trying to replace human crews, we're really just trying to take the dull, dirty, and dangerous work off their plates.
Sean Azimi is the dexterous robotics team leader at NASA. He said humanoid robots, which resemble humans, could potentially handle risky tasks in space, so astronauts can prioritize exploration and discovery. With the right software, he says a humanoid robot could use the same tools and equipment as humans. For instance, robots could be tasked with cleaning solar panels or inspecting malfunctioning equipment outside the spacecraft.
In particular, with a humanoid robot, it's very intuitive to be able to directly drive the arms and move the head. And that's what we're going to see with Valkyrie today. But when we're thinking ahead to operations from Earth, we will be operating with a much higher degree of autonomy, where the human operator on Earth will be more strategically giving the robot tasks, and the robot would be responsible for completing those tasks autonomously.
Back on Earth, NASA has partnered with robotic company Aptronik, which is based in Texas. It wants to learn how Aptronik's earthly robots could benefit future robots destined for space.
They want to see a viable system on Earth before we take these systems into space, into Mars, onto the moon.
Nick Payne is the chief technology officer of the firm, which has been developing Apollo, a humanoid robot whose earthly task will include working in warehouses and manufacturing plants. It is being developed to move packages and stack pallets. The company plans to start providing the humanoid robots to companies in early 2025. Payne says Apollo possesses clear advantages over its human counterparts, particularly endurance.
We're targeting having this system online 22 hours a day. And so there's multiple ways to do that. You can have a kind of trickle charge if you want to have a tether on the robot. Alternatively, this does have a swappable battery, so you can work for 4 hours swap the battery and then keep going in a very quick duration. So we're looking at kind of keeping the system online for the most amount of time that we can.
Robots like Apollo are designed with modularity in mind to be able to adapt to many applications. And you know, that's where NASA's really trying to get that insight to see what are the key gaps where we would need to invest in the future to bring a terrestrial system into the space environment and certified for operating in space.